sea, somewhere waiting for me. My lover stands on golden sand.
Hello everyone and welcome to a special episode of Royal Gaming Battalion's first episode of Bioshock the Collection. Before we get into the thick of it, my name is Joey, also known as Destronoma, and I'm joined today by...
Jack! Hello, everybody!
And what you guys are seeing in the background of this video is a montage of stuff we have done in the past, and there's a reason for that. Because this episode, our first episode of Bioshock, is our 100th episode on Royal Gaming Battalion.
No way!
With it being our 100th episode, I know for a lot of people... Maybe it's not a big deal, it's 100 episodes, but for us, this is a milestone, I feel like. And as such, I wanted to give a shout-out to some people that have really helped the channel to grow since 100 videos ago, pretty much.
Yeah.
This is in no order of importance, so the first shout-out goes to the Let's Play subreddit. You know, I don't really post there as much as I did in the past, but honestly, this subreddit helped to really propel us forward with what we were doing with this channel, with the hardware, and the games we were playing, and the commentary style, and it just... I can't thank you guys enough there. And the second shout-out I want to give out is to the Battleborn subreddit, which just... Our first Battleborn episode got like 200 views in a day.
Wow.
Almost 200 views. And so you guys have just been a really big help. You guys have made it very clear that Battleborn is something you guys want to watch on the channel, and it's not going anywhere, honestly. I think it's gonna stick around for a while, just because what else are we gonna, you know, play besides that? It's just been such a big game for us. Thank you so much. And I'll let Jack do this next shout out. So take it away.
My shout out is to our good friend Z-Man Stardust, otherwise known as Donovan. My code name for him is Donovan or Donnie. Donnie, thank you so much for your shout out on your channel for RGB. And sorry it's taken so long for us, but this is our official shout out to you. Thank you for being a huge supporter of ours, and thank you also for being a really great guy and a really great buddy to both me and Joey. And we hope to do a future collab project with you. So thank you very much, dude. We really appreciate you doing that for us, and we appreciate you being one of our biggest viewers. So.
And if you haven't had the chance to go check out his channel yet, it is a featured channel on ours. I think he does, like, Pokemon Nuzlocks.
Yeah.
And stuff like that, so if that's your thing, go give it a look.
He's pretty good at what he knows his stuff. So it really helps if you guys check him out. He's really intellectual about the stuff he presents, so yeah, give him a view. He's really good.
Yeah.
So...
And besides that, I wanted to give a shout out just to friends and family, people that have watched the channel or given us advice on how to fix it. I mean, there's been a few times where we've had audio issues and I'll get a text from like my brother saying, hey, your episode had, you know, you guys sounded too quiet or something. And so we go forward knowing the next episode, hey, we gotta fix the audio in it. And that's a very big help.
Yeah.
Is you guys watching, and not just watching, but giving us feedback. And, of course, thank you to you guys in the audience, whether you're just starting out or you've been with us since 100 videos ago, Rogue Legacy or the FNAF fan film. thank you so much.
Yeah, it really means a lot to both myself and Joey that you guys watch everything that we put out. Even if it's not something you're interested in, it's not always... The gameplay isn't always going to match the commentary. It's mostly because what we're talking about isn't always related to what you're seeing. So it's up to you guys. But I mean, like... this all started, like, months ago as just a dream. A dream and two guys that just love to shoot the breeze about anything. And look at us now. I mean, I'm very ecstatic about the fact that not only are we playing our first episode of Bioshock today, but it's also marking our 100th video that we've posted since we started RGB.
Yep.
All those months ago, and it just.
And as of today, we're at 52 or 53 subscribers, which, if you go and compare that to, like, the PewDiePies or the Markipliers out there, it's nothing. But for our first 3 or 4 months, 53 subscribers is
huge.
Is huge. So thank you guys so much.
Yeah.
For that. So.
And thank you to Joey for, like, I don't know if any of you guys are really aware of this, but Joey does a lot of the work behind the scenes on these videos, and he's going to start teaching me to, like, take care of some of the editing process and all that. And funny enough, Bioshock is going to be one of those beasts that I'm going to tackle as soon as I learn how to work with the editing software. But
So this first episode you guys are going to see is pretty much likely been done by me as a way to show Jack how to do it. But going forward, these later Bioshock episodes are all going to be done by him once he has the template for doing them.
Yeah.
So,
but
with that being said, I don't want to keep taking up your guys' time. You guys just sat through a 6-minute shout out. So all that being said, we're going to close up here and start playing Bioshock.
We love you guys. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Hello, everybody, and welcome to Royal Gaming Battalion's Let's Play of Rock. I am Jack, also known as GroovyAsh92, and as always, I am joined today by
Joey, also known as Destronoma. How's it going, guys?
I'm very excited. Do you know why?
Because we're playing Bioshock?
Yes, my absolute number one favorite game on modern consoles ever. I'm so excited.
So, for those of you guys wondering, yes, Bioshock is taking the place of Borderlands 2. It just is. There's really no other way to put it. That's a Let's Play channel. So, without further ado, what a difficulty are we going to be playing Bioshock on?
We can set it to normal. Fix the brain, even though I can see everything. Oh, they don't have a normal.
Medium would be normal.
Alright, so we're setting it to... So, one of the elements that I love about this game is the steampunk feel of it, as well as the 60s music and everything. Just the design, art deco,
the
and everything.
The atmosphere.
Yeah, just... Everything about this game is just to me.
It looks good, and this remake does it 60 frames per second. I believe it's in 1080p, too.
So good.
So, graphics. Son. Not too shabby.
I forgot to put on subtitles, darn it.
You were born to do. I just do it when you get in game.
Yeah, this isn't really story, but like he just says Oh, of all names.
What do you mean it's Jack? Come on. Let's be real.
No.
Bye.
forgot the last there's supposed to be a C.
I'm God, all... Viz?
Oh, God.
No.
I'm all shook up.
Misname our game? Oh, well.
That's
just... Oh, now we're wet.
Oh, I'm more than wet. I'm submerged.
Oh, that's unfortunate.
Hey.
Oh, lost my dang shirt.
I wasn't golfing.
Lost my purse.
I think it's funny how 60s fashion for men's shoes has pretty much devolved into that's just golf shoes now.
Lost my dang man purse. God, I hate when that happens.
As my math teacher likes to say, I'm in touch with my feminine side, thank you. Because he has a man purse.
Okay. So make sure you turn on subtitles.
Yeah. Do that real quick. They don't have it.
Dialogue subtitles on.
Yeah, art subtitles.
And then you just hit the A button.
Alright.
And you can probably turn up the volume on the TV a little bit so we can hear some stuff.
Yeah, it's not too bad. I'm gonna put it at 10.
Yeah. There we go.
So I've crash landed in the middle of the ocean. It's 1960, and I there's this mysterious lighthouse here, and my plane, the wreckage of my plane is sinking, like the fuselage and everything.
There's always a lighthouse.
Don't start with me.
There's always a girl and there's always a lighthouse.
Yep.
Yes, I did play Bioshock Infinite. I did not play the first or second one.
And you're playing it now. Well, I'm playing, but you're watching.
You play it.
I love this game way too much.
Mm-hmm. So, there is always a lighthouse.
Just look at all of this,
There's always a fire.
It's funny, too, how, like, the game box in this part of the level is, like, so basic, and you can definitely tell where, like, the shadow ends and, like, the nothingness begins.
I mean, it doesn't want you to swim out there.
Yeah, it pretty much has you on a linear track, but just looking at this now the way it does, it just looks so beautiful.
Looked better than it did when you tried to run it on PC.
Oh, God, that was a nightmare. So let's get into it.
Yeah, so our dedicated recording machine does not have a graphics card in it, so it cannot run the remastered version of Bioshock 1. Like, that poster that you guys are seeing right there...
It took 10 minutes for it to phase into view.
...would, like, pop in and out constantly.
Just look at that, man. Just
that poster.
Just look at that.
No gods or kings. Only propaganda.
Only man. In what country is there a place for people like me? Says Andrew Ryan.
No country for old men. Maybe.
Just the elements of this game are so spooky. I love it.
Mm-hmm.
Can't wait to see what the splicers look like.
Spooks.
Wow.
Wow.
The bathysphere. Everything looks so crisp in this.
Do you take a bath in it?
Cute.
Here we go. Try.
I know.
Under the sea.
Under the sea. Please be our guest. Under the sea. Under the sea.
I think you just mixed up two different things.
You ain't never had a friend like me. Under the sea.
Oh my god.
Ah! I keep forgetting that happens.
Oh, Five Nights at Freddy's. Fire at your fingertips. Quite literally. Just really reminds me that I need to play Burial at Sea.
Mm-hmm. It's a huge connecting point.
Mm-hmm.
I love this speech. Because in the original story, like the story of Andrew Ryan is he's a Russian immigrant who came to America to be a huge businessman and shipping and all that for manufacturing. And the whole novel Bioshock Rapture, oh my fucking god. I need a minute. Oh my god.
I think he's pretty amazed by the scenery.
Oh man, it looks so good.
Mm-hmm.
I've never seen it before.
Welcome to 2015?
17.
16? No,
this came out 2016.
Look, it's a big daddy. With a small girly.
What was I saying?
Can we just call him a bigly?
What was I saying? In Bioshock Rapture, the novel, it kind of explains the whole backstory of every character you encounter in this game. Andrew Ryan basically wanted to design a city where he wouldn't be basically constrained by God, government, or communism. Because it was the 60s and all that. So he basically made a city. And as you can imagine, placing a city like this under the water, it does a lot of crazy things to people.
You're submerged.
Not only that, but like you basically are cutting yourself off from the rest of the world. Saying that everyone have freedom when there's not... He also didn't allow propaganda like Bibles, government-related things, and shipping stuff sent in.
Touts freedom when there's really no freedom.
Exactly. Which I think is kind of the irony of it. And it's sad, but... Oh, God, this part.
I just realized we sang on here earlier, and there's actually a parody of that song for Bioshock.
For Bioshock, yeah. I don't remember the lyrics, but it
gosh,
was...
Gosh, I'm dumb.
No, that's all good.
How could I forget? You haven't gotten. I don't need it anymore. I'm God above my own. Well, stabbed.
That's very violent.
Well, best get dying. She looks like a nice young lady.
I don't know. I'd fuck her.
Well, that's just one place. Went to Rapture of all places. I think she's gonna try to tear down the door. Sounds of exertion. I think you're exerting. Arr! Is that what exertion sounds like?
I don't know.
Oh, Jesus. Gotta get the hell out of here. Get the Escalade. Grab the radio. Nah, I don't think I will. I aim to keep you alive. Thank you, Atlas.
Stop doing that.
No. Shadow Moses.
Oh my god. Just.
You're gonna need to draw her out of hiding. Maybe with a pencil and paper. You could literally draw her not hiding.
We're not your property. Let it end. Let us ascend. Ryan doesn't own us. Rapture is dead.
Wow, these people really wanted to get out of here.
Yeah.
She'll wrap you in the sheet.
That's nice of her.
Make you a blanket.
I'm pretty cold. It's under the water, so it's
I'll keep you warm.
It's pretty cold under the water.
She's dancing. A great flying... I don't know. Can't think of a name for her. The great flying Brigizzi.
Braganza.
Braganza the Gonzo. Ah! That's funny!
Oh, God!
Oh, that's a burning desk. And I'm a burning bush.
I'm a hunk of burning love.
And I'm a bleeding volcano.
Oh, hello. Bye-bye.
Dink. Badonkadonk.
Oh, he looks much better graphically.
I would hope so.
How are you?
What if they didn't upscale the enemies in graphics? So everything else looks 1080p, but everything else looks like it was made in 2007. At least where the enemies are concerned.
Yeah, right.
Well, these environments look really great, but why are all the enemies pixelated messes?
They're poorly rendered as fuck.
Come on, 2K, get on it. Just realized we can play a lot of 2K games on here. And
yeah, right?
And a lot of games that start with the letter B.
You know?
Or have the letter B somewhere in it.
I just realized that now.
Think about it. Breath of the Wild, Battleborn, Borderlands, Bioshock, Battlefront, Bogue Begacy, Bulverwatch,
Five Nights at Betty's,
Barvo versus Bat Bomb 2.
A Bat Bomb!
There's some days where you just can't get rid of a bomb.
You're right about that, Batman. Alright, so let's see what this shit does.
Take a needle, stick it in my arm, see what it does.
It's some heroin.
Grab an adrenaline. I mean, heroin.
He just jams that into his arm. He doesn't put it into a
vein.
He
doesn't even make the right sound. The correct sound for that would be...
Well,
the more accurate sound would be... Can't wait to see the playback on that and hear how that sounds. It's going to sound great.
Yeah. There you go.
I like turning and almost having the microphone in my eye.
Ah, God.
I can see sounds and hear colors.
I can see sounds and hear colors. From?
Drugs.
Oh. Personal
Whoa,
experience?
Catman. And cat.
So you mean Fairly Odd Parents?
Yeah. Seems to... Okay, he's...
Mm. Yeah, one part of the first... The original version of the first game that they should have still tried to clean up.
What?
Like the mouth movement that guy had?
No, I was gonna say his mouth just looked... It seems...
No.
Oh, thank God our saviors are here.
This is fresh. I'm serious. Like, this looks much cleaner than it does in the original game.
Mm-hmm. Beatrix. Before she grew up. You know what?
Actually? That, you know what?
No, look, she has a needle for
I
an
know,
arm.
I know. Well, it's not an arm. It's, she's holding it.
That looked like it was a needle on her arm.
What if... What's her name? Beatrix?
Beatrix.
What if Beatrix basically was a grown-up little sister that, like, repurposed a little... Like, a big daddy to be her new body?
All right, so...
Like, holy crap.
So Beatrix is a grown-up little sister, and Marquis is Sir Hammerlock? But then who was Phone?
Phone?
It's an old meme.
Oh.
Never mind.
Then who is Phone? I don't know, Joey. You tell me.
I wouldn't know either. I don't have that number. I'm just going to stick a needle into myself. I can go and shock people.
Oh, it's the same. I forget. I have a PS2 version of this game. PS3. Sorry. PS3. There we go. That becomes...
The PS2 version where
very
everything
useful
looks
later.
Like Legos.
Ah.
Oh, well, there's part of your plane. Just don't shock the water. Kill yourself.
Actually, that doesn't work as much in this game. They didn't... Well, they might have redid it in this game.
I don't really want to find out. No, you're going for a ride. Whee!
I'm in raging waters.
Well, never mind.
Nope. Get out.
I wonder if that'll break if you sit there off.
No.
Damn. Rip in pieces.
Biggest part about this game is you gotta pick up everything you find.
It's like Fallout.
Yeah.
Just there's... minus the expansive world. Well, that's a cat.
That makes me sad. I love cats, especially now that I've got a new one.
Okay. Roller rink and splicer.
And where did she go?
Told you. Rollerblades. God's gift to man.
Lure him down here into the
I'm
water.
Not sure I like him. Bink!
This is exactly how that went.
Can that just be the sound effect for every time you hit him?
Bink!
Bink!
Bink! I'm going back.
Snap the new Mamba.
Okay.
Alright, he's on fire.
Oh, I'm out of plasmid.
Smackity smackity!
Am I gonna get a gun at some point, or...
What are guns when you have a wrench?
What are guns to a god? What's a god to a non-believer? Ah!
Do you believe now? I got a family. It's not important, but it's exposition. The exposition.
Let's begin.
The exposition. Here I win. Hey, just stop texting people.
I'm not talking to anyone.
Not you. People texting you.
Oh.
Would you stop banging on that door down there?
You're not getting in.
Hey!
You're not getting in. You're not getting in. You're not getting in.
Break the glass.
There is no glass, only Zool. Oh.
There's another poster. Oh, that poor Fazbear.
The great chain is guided by our hand.
God, I miss Comstock. Oh, yeah, I remember that was one of the creepiest imageries in the game.
This?
Mm-hmm.
Isn't it funny how the shadow is worse?
Her hand is kind of disjointed.
There's no hand on her left. She has a left nub.
No, she's holding a...
Oh, she's holding a wrench.
Bar.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. Kujikuru. Okay, that's a creepy poster on my... Oh, see, there's a revolver. Yeah. Oh, good job. Lady was trying to...
She was trying to coup a revolver? That?
Yeah.
Oh, it's like one of my favorite artworks from Bioshock. I want that as a poster in my room.
Good. Hope you don't wake up in the middle of the night and it's like right in front of you.
Masquerade.
No, Mama Bunny Puss. Oh, you have a hole for bullets.
Not anymore.
Wow, you just wasted them all. Why'd you do that? Happy New Year! Oh, well, now you're drunk.
Fuck you, Cher. You're not my father.
Well, you were drunk for about 2 minutes.
I wish that was a real thing.
Sobriety looks or works very weird here.
You're not my father.
You're just a chair. You're just the thing I said on.
You don't know you're beautiful.
Should you really be wasting ammo when you only have 2 bullets?
You can get
you
more
do
later.
Have a wrench.
I do.
You should smack him with it. Smack diddly yak. I'm out and you're stuck being a bitch. Oh. You almost died. Kill yourself.
Is there anything she has that I can use? No?
No, you took everything that she had.
Alright, well, it did give me that option, but whatever. Oh, there we go.
You have no ammo, so you should probably switch to your wrenchity wrench.
Yeah.
And just go and wrench him to death.
Hey, but I'm rich.
Oh, now you do have ammo.
Mm-hmm.
Just reload your gun.
Bergonzer.
I'm some type of Bergonzer. You mean Gunzerker?
That's a good way to kill him.
Oh. I'm not sure where they came from, though.
They came from upstairs.
They came from under the floor.
Under the sea.
Oh, good.
Under the sea. Oh, my.
Darling, it's better. Downwards, wetter.
Take it from me.
Take it from my...
Oh, well, that didn't work.
Well, time to give up. 2 minutes into the game and I'm already lost? I quit.
That was me a couple of years ago. I don't remember what game, though.
It was this
Whoa!
One. Whoa, hey, lady. Whoa, Meg, you startled me.
Okay.
Well, do you always die like that? Oh god, you're getting close to Slender.
Oh yeah, this is something that happens a lot in this game.
Okay, do you hallucinate?
You see plasmid ghosting.
Hmm.
Basically what happens if you share needles with some other people, you see the genetic ghosts of them. Like in the past. It's weird, the science of it doesn't make sense, but at any rate.
But when does it ever? It's a video game, it doesn't have to make sense. Oh, good thing I peed.
Mm.
You want a hot piss of pee? Hey, it's not good to pick up people's diary.
He's got nothing.
But he's got clothes on, ain't he, clothes? Oh, that was kind of creepy.
Yep, this game does a lot of it.
Oh good, a lot of jump scares.
Get to the, until we get to the, Adia area, the gardens.
Oh good.
That's gonna be scary as fuck. Especially with this graphics looking better now.
Probably not as scary as being chased by George Washington robots with machine guns. Ah!
I don't know. It's cute, but... Oh, that's what I do all the time. That's why I'm a parent. I'm not. I am not a parent. It's not apparent that I'm a parent.
Well, can't jump. Can't climb. Guess I'm stuck.
Oh, here we go.
The big daddy's gonna...
Fuck him up. Oh, not her. Him.
Don't go to Beatrix. Oh, well, he's pissed. Does it really look like the pistol's all that effective against the big daddy? No. You have no guts. Don't you play as a big daddy in the second?
Yeah, and then the end of this one, you actually get to dress up as a big daddy to get something.
I think he's dead.
Now I gotta search him.
Give me his ammo.
Happy Chappy.
Oh, that was the best movie I'd ever seen. I remember it starred,
Sandra Cohen.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And Elizabeth.
Really?
I don't know.
Songbird?
So yeah, it was Songbird. I'm not afraid of God. But I am afraid of you. You having fun beating your meat?
It's pretty much what they are now, is meat.
Well, that's one way to think of it. Ow, my bunny mask!
I love how they're like, how dare you disrespect me?
Ah, my mask! I spent like 5 hours on that!
Papier-mâché!
I was cosplaying, you dick!
Oh my god.
Eat barrel!
Eat barrel! My impression of Neil Patrick Harris. Not Neil Patrick Harris, I'm sorry. David Hyde Pierce. Eat barrel, you ruffian! I love him. He's so funny.
Freedom on the road, only 1 mil. She's 11, and I'm fucking 90.
Is it sad that she actually looked less than 11 years old?
She might have been, like, 9. I don't know.
If Cass ever wants to do a cosplay, definitely cosplay as
X-23. Oh, they killed the Big Daddy.
It was already dead.
Oh, they killed the Big Daddy. Than physics, though. Just can't wait for it to, like, jump up and choke your character. Okay, thanks, die.
Oh, God. Oh, God, no. Oh, God, no.
Oh, God, no.
Oh,
God, 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 no. You're gonna die. Tell my wife and kids I hate them.
Tell my wife and kids I got to second base. Oh! Oh
<my. laughs> Wow.
Yeah.
Whoa, lady, watch where you're.
Oh my god, damn.
Hagabag!
Hugagabooey!
A bugaboy!
Oh my god, I swept your I swept your leg, bitch!
Wow, I think you just pulled a Danielson.
Sweep the leg! Sweep the leg!
Don't do it, it's cheating. Oh.
Fuck. Well, that sucks.
You gotta watch your health meter.
I know, I'm usually very good at this.
Yeah. Swing, swing. Jeez. Alright, guys. Well, he's... beating the corpses over there. I think this is a good time to go ahead and bring this episode of Bioshock to a close. It's the very beginning of the game, but you know what? Looks like it's going to be a lot of fun.
Yeah.
So, as usual, my name is Joey, also known as Destronoma, and I am joined by...
Jack, otherwise known as GroovyAsh92.
Thank you very much for joining us on our first episode of Bioshock 1, which is part of the Bioshock Collection. Take care.
Bye-bye. Once I ran to you.